This is a continuation video on analysis of time series. In the last video lectures, we have discussed the measurement of trend, and we have discussed the one type of measurement of trend that is called a moving average method. Now we are going to study the another type of measurement, that is least square method, and this is the most preferable measurement because it tells the exact trend. And that is that helpful in analysis of trend when we have a linear regression, right? So what we do in the case of least square method? Least square method. See, this is very simple. And this chapter is basically related to the regression, right? So what we do in the linear equation, sorry, least square method. See, in the least square method, we have a trending line which goes like this, right? And how do we calculate this trend? That is with the help of the equation, that is you have already studied regression, that is y equal to a plus bx, right? A represent that is intercept, right? And b represent the slope, right? And x is a independent variable, where y is a independent variable, right? And this is a plus sign, that means we can say that means if the x unit increases by 1 unit, then y also increases by how much unit? It depends on the slope, right? So in the least square method, that means least square, that means why do we say least, right? See, in this equation, you know very well, there is another concept, or you can say there is another variable that is called residual, or you can say the error term, right? Because the y variable, that is the dependent variable, we can't say that is it is purely dependent on the one variable. It might be there are some other factors, right? So, but here in this chapter, we are following only the one type of independent variable. We are not discussing about the multiple regression, or against multiple variables. We are discussing about the linear trend, right? Where we have only two variables, that means one is independent and another one is dependent. But in the practical life, we know that the y dependent variable doesn't depend on the x variable. There are more than one variable, right? So what we do, we actually write e, that is called the error term, or you can say this is also known as the residual, right? So here the error term basically means the difference between the actual mean and the trend, right? That means the actual data, right, and the expected data. We want to minimize the difference between the actual data and the expected data. So the difference is called error term, right? So to minimize that difference, we follow the least square method. I repeat, the error term. See, let me write. The error term basically means the actual data minus expected data minus expected data. If there is a difference, means if there is a more difference, that means suppose say if the actual data is 100, right, and expected data is 50, right? So that means there is an error term and it is a positive. So that means we can say that we have underestimated, right? We can say that we have underestimated, and if it is negative, we can say that is we have overestimated. Okay, in both ways we can say that we have error term, right? So minimize the difference, that is called, that's how we are going to apply least square method, right? So for this we need to apply this trend analysis. You can say this equation, that is yc, Y stands for, that is YC, that is called the trend. How do we calculate trend? That is A plus B X, right? In this trend method, we need to calculate the value of A and B. Okay, in this trend analysis, we need to calculate the value of A and the value of B. Then how to calculate a value of A and B? With the help of two equations. That is, if in this whole equation, if I just you can say, if I just summation of this equation, right, like summation of y equal to n a plus b sigma x, right, this is the equation number one. And with the help of this, we need another equation, right? So in this equation, we are going to simply multiply the variable x, right? So that is sigma x y equals to a sigma x plus b sigma x square. Here is, we have second equation. Now we only need to one thing here, that is we need to equate this equation, and we need to find out the value of a and b. That's it. And once we find out the value of a and b, we will simply put in this equation and we will get the trend, right? So how do we calculate the value of a and b? See, as I told you that we need to minimize the differences. That means with the help of least square method, we need to actually minimize the error term, right? So to minimize that error term, what we do, that is in this equation, in the least square method, we basically need to follow the two conditions. We need to follow the two conditions. What are those? First, summation of y minus yc is always equal to 0. Simple. The difference between y minus yc is equal to 0. Y in the sense the y minus s in the sense that is the actual, and yc is equal to actually the trend, that is the expected. So we are going to minimize, that is we have assumed that it is equal to 0, and simply the square of these also equal to 0. All right, so in the least square method, we need to follow these two conditions, right? Now suppose we have the trend like this, like suppose 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So what we do to apply the least square method, we actually we take the base from the middle, right? So we take the difference like this, like minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. And if we take the summation of this, we will get 0. We will get 0, right? So for this, that means we can say that in this equation, that means in the equation 1 and equation 2, this sigma x would be equal to 0, right? This sigma x would be equal to 0. Now in this case, suppose the sigma x is equal to 0. So how do we calculate the value of b? See, sigma x equal to 0, so that means we have left with sigma y, that is equal to n a. And we need to calculate the a, so that is a equal to sigma y equal to n, right? So that means we can say that is equal to y mean, right? And for the equation number 2, that means where sigma x is equal to 0, right? So how do we calculate the value of b? So in this case, that is we have left with sigma x y equal to b sigma x square, right? So that means b equal to sigma x y divided by sigma x square. That's it. So that means for a, under least square method, how do we calculate a? That is, we need to simply calculate the y mean. And for b, we need to calculate the sigma, or the product of a and b, sorry, the product of sigma xy divided by sigma x square. That's it. Right? So this is the way of calculating the a and b y to calculate the trend. Right? So let's do the question so that you need so that you have better clarity. Read question number 4. Below are given the figures of production in thousands quintals of a sugar factory. Year is given starting from 2013 and the end is 2019, and we have also given that is the production. So we need to find out the fit a straight line trend to these figures, and the then we need to estimate the trend. Okay, so let's start with the question number 4. See, we have given the years as well as the production. Okay, and so we assume that this production, that is equal to y, right? So for the trend, let's start with the equation yc equal to a plus bx. This is the our trend equation, right? So since the sigma x is equal to 0, right? So how do we calculate a? That is equal to sigma y divided by n, and b, that means b equal to sigma x y divided by sigma x square, right? So for this, first we need sigma x y. So first we simply calculate the summation of this. So that is equal to 630. Okay, so that means the sigma y equal to 630, right? And n, that is the how many number of years? That is 7. So that means a equal to 630 divided by 7. So that is equal to 19, right? Now we need to calculate the b. So that means first we need the value of x. First we need the value of x. How do we calculate the x? First we need to take the base year, right? So we need to take that base year preferable, so that the x equal to 0, because we are assuming that this, since the x is x simple sigma x equal to 0, right? So how do we calculate the x equal to 0? So simply we will take the base from the middle year, right? So here we are taking the base year, that is 2016, right? And for this you need to write on the top that you have assumed that the base year that you have taken, that is equal to 2016. You need to write this, right? So x equal to, how do we calculate the x? Simply 2016 minus 2016, that is equal to 0. 2013 minus 2016, that is minus 13. Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. So that means the value of sigma x, that is equal to 0, right? Now next we need to calculate the value of sigma x square, right? We need to calculate the value of x square. So simply we just square these all the values: 9, 4, 1, 0, 1, 4, and 9, right? And the total is, that is 28. Now we need to calculate the product of x and y. Calculate the product of x and y. So the product of x and y would be, that is 80 minus 80 multiplied by minus 3, that is minus 240, minus 180, minus 92, 0, 94, 198, 276, right? And the total is, that is 56. right? So for the equation of B, this sigma xy that is equal to 56 and this sigma x square that is equal to 28. So that is equal to 2. That's it. So that means the trend, we can say that is yc equal to 90 plus 2x. This is the trend equation that we have found, right? This is the trend equation. Now they have also asked to estimate the trend. So for this we need to make the another column for the trend. That is yc. Okay. So that is the equation we have found out, that is 90 equal to 2x. 90 equal to 2x. So we just need to put up the value of x in each every year, right? So that means that is 90 plus 2x would be equal to minus 3 in the first year. So that is 90 minus 6, that is equal to 84, right? Then 90 minus 4, that is equal to 86, then 88, then 90, then 92, then 94, and then 96, right? So that means the summation of yc that would be equal to 630. That's it. All right. See, in this question we have taken the base year, or you can say the origin, we have taken the middle of the series of year, that is 2016, right? And now we have another method, that is it doesn't mean that we have to take the only the middle year as base or as origin. We take so that we our equation are get simplified, but we can take the base year, that is 2013 also, that is first year we can also take, right? But the thing is that the calculation becomes more complicated. So I always suggest to take always take the origin from the middle year, right? But if you take the base year as origin, the first year, the answer would be the same, right? So you can do like this. Like suppose this is the first method. Like if we take origin 2016 as base, and another method that you can do at your own, that is if we take the origin 2013 as origin, right? The answer would be same, right? Chaliye, now move on to next question number 5. Fit a straight line trend for the following series, estimate the value of 2023, right? So that means this question is more or less same, right? So you just need to calculate the estimate the value of trend, that is 2023. See, we have given the years, that is starting from 2013 till 2019 only, and they are asking for to estimate the value of 2023. So how do we calculate this value? It is not very difficult. The thing is, you just need to simply put up the value of x in the trend equation. Like suppose here we can also estimate the value of trend 2023. How do we calculate? We have find out this trend, that is yc equal to 90 plus 2x, right? We just need to put up the value of x, that's it. So how do we calculate the value of x? See, in 2019 the value of x is, that is 3. So what would be the value of the x in 23? That is 7, right? So just you need to calculate the value of that is yc equal to 90 plus 2 multiplied by 7. So that is yc equal to 90 plus 14, that is equal to 204. This is the trend for the year 2023. That's it. All right. So question number 5 is also very simple. So this question 5 is for homework. Now move on to next question number 6. Fit a straight line trend by method of least square for to the following data, assuming that the same rate of change continues, what would be the predicted earning for the year 2021? Alright, so we have given years starting from 2012 till 2019, and we also given the earning values. The difference here is that earlier in the first two questions of the least square method, the number of years are given, that is in the odd, but here we have given the number of years in the even. Okay, and as I told you, when we have odd series, we just need to simply take the origin from the middle year. But how do we calculate in the case of even? How do we calculate in the case of even? For this, again, we need to simplify the equations, or we can simplify the calculations. How do we calculate? So here is the basic format when we have the years in the even, right? That is starting from 2012, and the end is, that is 2019. Now the number of year is, that is 8, right? So what we do is, that is, we will take the average of the middle 2 years. We will take the average of 2 middle years. That is, that would be 2015.5. So first step is, that is, we will take the deviation from 2015.5, right? So that would be, that is, minus 3.5, then minus 2.5, minus 1.5, minus 0.5, positive 0.5, 1.5, 2.5, and 3.5, right? This is step number 1. Then in this step number 2, we will calculate the final value of x by multiplying the deviation, that is multiply by 2, right? So that would be 7, 5, 3, sorry, multiply by 2, minus 7, minus 5, minus 3, minus 1, 1, minus 3, minus 5, minus 7. Now we will get the value of x, that is equal to 0, right? So this is the way of calculating the value of x, that is equal to 0, that is, we take deviation from the 2 middle years, right? Take the average of 2 middle years and then take deviation, right? Now the rest steps are same. Then now we have the value of x. Now simply take the product of x and y, that is 38 multiplied by minus 7, minus 266, minus 200, minus 195, minus 72, sorry, plus 69, 180, 435, and 665. The total is 616. Now simply we'll take the square of x, that is 49, 25, 9, 1, 1, 9, 25, 49, and the total would be 168. That's it. Now we just simply put all the values in the formulas. So A, that is equal to sigma y. Okay, so the total here is 526. So sigma y, that is 526 divided by 8, and that would be equal to 65.75. For B, sigma xy, that is equal to 616, sigma x square, that is equal to 168, and that is equal to 3.3. 6, 7, right? So that means here we get the trend equation YC equal to 65.75 plus 3.67x, right? I think they have asked another thing, yes. What would be the predicted earning for the year 2012? So year, for the year 2012, the x would be, x ki value kya hogi for the year 2009, that is 5.5, right? 5.5. So YC equal to 65.75 plus 3.67 multiplied by 5.5. So YC equal to 85.92, right? And we have, that is in the earning, so that is equal to in rupees. And okay, all right, yes. So this is the way of calculating the trend in the with the help of least square method, right? Moving to next question number 7. Below are given the figures of production in 1000 quintals of sugar factory starting from year 2013 till 2022, right? Fit a straight line method by least square method and tabulate the trend values. What is the monthly increase in the production of sugar? Now this is a very good example. So if we see, if we closely look at the series of years, we can see that after 2013 we have direct 2015. That means 2014, the year is skipped. Then 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Then after 19 we have that year, that is 22. That means 20, 21, 2 years are not there. So if we have this kind of series, so how do we calculate or you can say how do we get the trend equation with the help of the least square method, right? So in this case the thing is that you can just simply put all the values like we have done earlier. You don't need to change any kind of method. That means we need to follow all the steps that we have done earlier, right? So what we do is we have how many number of years given, that is 7. So first we simply take the middle year, that is 2017, as base, as origin, right? And but here the x, sigma x value would not be equal to 0, right? Would not be equal to 0. Okay, so let's do this question number 7. So here we have the basic format of this. I have written the number of years, that is this number of years is 7. And I have also write the values of y. Now we simply follow all the steps that we have done earlier. The first, simply we take the 2017 as origin. So in this case the value fx would be minus 4, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and 5. And in this case, this sigma x would be equal to 1. That means in this case, this sigma x is not equal to 0. So what we do, that means we can't find the value of the a and b that we have done earlier. So in this case, the method would be changed. So okay, now let's move. Now we need to calculate the product of x and y. So that is equal to minus 308, minus 176, minus 94, 0, 91, 196, 415, and the summation of this would be 159. Now, it would be x square, not y square, x square. Now, and the value of 16, 4, 1, 0, 1, 4, 25. And the summation is 51, right? Now here, since the sigma x is not equal to 0, so what we do? Now in this case, we need to calculate the value of a and b with the help of those two equations, right? So we have the two equations here, these two equations, right? That is sigma x y equal to n a plus b sigma x. First write those equations. Sigma y equal to n a plus sigma x, right? And then sigma x y equal to a sigma x plus sigma x square, right? So in this case, we need to simply put all the values in these two equations, right? So sigma y, that is equal to 623 equal to n, that is how many number of years we have, that is 7a plus b sigma x, right? We have b sigma x, b sigma x and b sigma x square. So in this case, we have sigma x, that is equal to b equal to 1, so we have left with b. Now in this second equation, this sigma x y, that is equal to 159 equals to a plus 51b, right? So that means if we equate both these equations, we will get the value of a and b, right? So after this, if we calculate, if we equate both the equations, the value of a would be 88.803 and the value of b would be 1.38. That's it. Now we will get the trend equations, that is yc equal to 88.81 or 80 3 plus 1.38x. That's it. So this is the way of calculating the trend equations when we have this kind of situations. So first they have asked fit a statement, okay, and the what is the monthly increase in the production of sugar. So that means first we need to calculate the trend equations of trend values. That means in this case we will get 83.283, then 86.043 87.43 88.803 90.183 91.563 95.703, and the summation of this would be 623, right? Now they have asked you what is the monthly increase in the production of x, monthly increase in the production of x. See, this is the equation in the annual, on annual based, right? So that means we have to simply convert this value into month. See, what is the value, what is the meaning of this figure, that is 1.3. this is the slope value. That means in the increase in the unit of x, the value of y would be increased by 1.38, right? So that means if it is increased annually, right? So what we do, we will just simply divide this value by 12. So that means 0.115 thousand quintals would be monthly increase in the production of sugar. That's it. So this is the final answer, right? So here we have the question number 7, right? Now we have completed the this time, that is the least square method, right? And the rest we will do in the next video lectures. Thank you.